then you stop it. So you are taking that your joy is the factor for you to do this. So it's not only the question of joy, even it's painful that it has to, you have to go through. That's what it is. ఇప్పుడు మనకి ఇష్టమైతేనే చేస్తాం, ఇష్టం కాకపోతే మానేస్తాం. దాంట్లో నెక్స్ట్ ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దే ఆర్ గివింగ్ ఇన్ ద వెరీ నెక్స్ట్ సెంటెన్స్ దే ఆర్ గివింగ్ ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇళయ పెరుమాడై పోలే ఇరువరుమాన సీర్తిలే అడిమై செய்கை முறை. డూయింగ్ ద సర్వీస్ టు బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ లక్ష్మణ ఈజ్ ద బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. సి రామ ఈజ్ ఎ రూల్ ఫర్ హిమ్ టు గో టు ద ఫారెస్ట్. సీత బికాస్ షీ ఈజ్ హిస్ స్పౌస్ సో షీ జస్ట్ కాంట్ లివ్ away from him, she also followed. What for Lakshmana? Why he has to go to forest along with Rama? Is it really necessary for him to go? Huh? Is it a mandatory? No. Or is there anybody to insist on him? Did Rama ask him to come? Then why should he go? But is it a place where, you know, he can go and just, you know, play on the ridings? You know, roller coaster and other stuff? You know, eating a ice cream and just, you know, just playing something around? Is it for such place Lakshmana is going? Or is it just, you know, for a vacational tour that he is going on? It's very painful things that he is crossing through, following them. Because he is the one who took care of every activity of Rama and Lakshmana, Rama and Sita, carrying all the material that whatever they have with them, and also to serve 24 hours. Is it a joyful thing that he has chosen? No. It's a painful forest he is going through. But still, he wanted to go there. వాంటెడ్ టు సర్వ్ దే. సో జాయ్ అయితేనే వెళ్ళి చేయాలి నియమం లేదు. ఈవెన్ దో ఇట్స్ పెయిన్ఫుల్ దట్ హీ గోస్ త్రూ, హీ గాట్ జాయ్ నాట్ ఫర్ హిస్ సేక్, దట్ ఆల్సో ఫర్ దేర్ సేక్. ఫర్ హిస్ జాయ్ హీ డిడ్ నాట్ గో బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ హిస్ వెరీ నేచర్ టు సర్వ్ దెమ్. ఇట్స్ వెరీ నేచర్ ఇస్ టు సర్వ్ దెమ్. దట్స్ వై హీ వెంట్. So it is Sita, you know, who says some interesting statement. When Rama and Sita, Lakshmana, came to Atri Anasuya's ashram while just entering the forest, it was night. They stayed in the ashram. Rama was sitting with Atri Maharshi and he was just chatting. Anasuya was sitting with Sita. I knew she was very much fascinated and asked Sita, "Oh Sita, you are really lucky, enough, you know, so nice girl. Can you tell me how your marriage happened?" Then Sita explained, you know, everything, whatever happened during the marriage occasion. And after listening to the whole thing, Anasuya said, "You know, Rama is a really pretty, you know, a beautiful boy and with so many great qualities. So I think who lady will not follow such a husband, you know, like Rama?" Just as a passing statement, she said that. Suddenly Sita got upset and said, "I'm sorry. I did not follow because Rama is really beautiful and great with qualities. So I don't accept that. Withdraw that statement." Even Rama was not having any good qualities, I would have followed him. Rama may be the worst guy in the world, still I would have followed him. You know why? Because when the marriage was done, my dad said, "You should follow him like a shadow. Don't leave him anywhere." కొంతమంది భార్యతో పడలేక అప్పుడప్పుడు ఎక్కడికో పోతుంటారు, అక్కడ కూడా వదలదండి ఆవిడ. స్వర్గానికి వెళ్ళినా అని అక్కడికి వెళ్ళినా ఆవిడ చీపురు కట్ట పట్టుకుని రెడీగా ఉంటుందండి, పేదవా ఎక్కడికి పోతామని. సో My dad said, follow him like a shadow. That's why I followed, that's all. It's not because Rama is good. It's not because Rama is having so many good qualities. You would have known if Rama would have been a person without qualities, whether I follow him or not. Lord Sita said. Gunalunte ever preminsarandi, evadane premistadu. గుణాలు లేనప్పుడే ప్రేమించగలిగితే కదండి నిజమైన ప్రేమ అంటేను. చిత్ర రాముడే కనుక గుణాలు లేనివాడు అయి ఉంటే అప్పుడు తెలుసుండేది నాకెంత ప్రేమ ఉండేదో రాముడి మీద. దిస్ ఇస్ ద స్టేట్మెంట్ వాట్ సీత సెట్ యునో. సో బికాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ జాయియస్ సో వీ సర్వ్ గాడ్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఎనీబడి ఫీల్స్ ఇట్ అండ్ వెదర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ జాయియస్ ఆర్ నాట్ It's your nature to do it. That's why you do it. That's all. Comes in, joy comes. It is his joy. And even pain comes. That also for him. That is where you see the Prahlada. See, father gave him poison. Just he simply drank it. He did not object. Because the pain that comes out of his house is not for me. Why should I feel? Because I have to do it. Do it. That's it. And when he threw him to the fire, still he did not object. He did not condemn the father, nor he pleaded God, nor he cried for God. That's okay. When he is there, then when should I feel anything sad or bad or whatever it is? So nothing happened. Ante anta powerful feeling kanaka if you are able to really get, I think even the external things also will not show any impact on you. To that level you reach. And probably that is the reason. Otherwise, you know, we are affected with the external things, right? More often. But for Prahlada, no external thing ever affected him. I think that is a kind of situation what I think the mantra wanted us to reach. Ultimately, in your heart, that also in your heart, but physically you have to speak everything out. I did, I got, mine is this achievement. If you won't say that in the office, you won't survive, you'll be fired. And people around you will push you down without any compassion. So orally, verbally and physically you have to do everything that you are supposed to do in the world. Let it not be there in the manas. What we call that pongu, kungu. What do you call that? Depression or oppression. Where does it happen? In the heart. So that need not be there. But physically anything happens and what you have to say, you have to say. No? If somebody asks you who did it, and you are supposed to say, I did it. I. You have to say that. And if you don't say, no, it's God did. That means he thinks something went wrong with you. And then immediately he'll be calling another doctor and then he'll put you there. So it's what the mantra talks here about, everything related to the jnana. The change we wanted there. As I said, you know, before, the problem started there. So the repair also started there. And rectification also takes place there. And a state of not getting through the reactions also should be there. But physically everything will be there. You touched snow, no reaction. You touched fire, no reaction. Means that it is a corpse. Without any reactions. And you are not supposed to be without any reactions. You should go through the reactions physiologically. Everything comes, right? When there is cold, and if you don't feel it, and if there is a hot, burning sun and you never feel, that means there is something wrong with your body. Understand? And that is not what the mantra says, talks about. These things must be there. You know, somebody said once, you know, he came to us and Swamiji, we want to take sannyasam. And not with me, with our Swamiji. And Swamiji said, that's okay. What about your family background? He said, you know, I have a wife and I have four children and everybody is there. And then, did you perform the marriages of children? Not yet. Then Swamiji said, don't worry, just wait for a while. Let the responsibilities be cleared. Then you can just do it. Then he was just waiting for some more years. Then later again he has come. He said, Swamiji, just I finished all my responsibilities. I'm married. Marriage performance is done for all the four children. Then, what about your wife? Well, she's there. And then, you know, wait for some more time. And then, you know, because that's another responsibility that you have. After a couple of years again he came. And then, Swamiji, now I became really great. You know, because, you know, I have no responsibilities. I came to a stage when my wife dead, I did not cry. Yes, I reached that vairagyam. So give me sannyasam, Swamiji. Then Swamiji said, you know, now you need another marriage, not sannyasam. And he was shocked. What, Swamiji, what are you saying? Are the person who shared your life, when passed away you did not cry, means when you are not able to cry for your wife, and how can you cry for the people who are suffering somewhere? How can you cry for the nature which is damaging? How can you cry for the animals which are there? You know, because the sannyasam is to spread your concern for the whole world, for the benefit of the world. And when you are not able to cry for the wife who shared your life, how can you cry for those things? And so your manas became are still like an iron piece. It's not tender. Huh? It's so tight now. So you don't need sannyasam now. So you need another marriage now. Immediately. So physically the reactions always should be there. You know, if somebody passes away, you have to cry. That shows the tenderness in your heart. Somebody is enjoying something, you feel the joy also. That shows, you know, your concern for others. This is physical. But in the heart, say God. God, oh, he's suffering, just take care of him. And when somebody is joy, God, you are blessing him. Spread that joy to all. It needs to be there in your heart, you know, that is heart. So what you have to fix up with all these feelings is the heart with faith in him. But otherwise, the external body goes through all the things. It has to. Understand? That is what mantra talking about, the jnana part of it. Okay. So Lakshmana, when he was as Sita, I gave you an example of Sita, right? Even it is not for my joy, because crossing through the woods, walking on the thorns and stones, it's not a joyous thing, right? But she accepted. But she felt nothing. But she must have said, ah, when there is a thorn. But it was for Rama. It is a physiological reaction that comes, but the one who suffered was Rama. They have such a close feeling, you know. So also Lakshmana, when he went to Kishkindha, Sugriva, Hanuman saw them and asked, who you are? And then Lakshmana introduced himself to Rama, saying, according to Rama, I am his brother. But according to me, he is my boss. He is my Swami. That's all it is. Swami means Yajaman, owner. I'm just like his belonging. That's all it is. And how did he become? Because Rama has great qualities. So just I simply followed him to the forest. Gunaihi dasyam upagataha. Ahamasya varo bhrata, he said. Oh. Because Rama has so many good qualities, you became his servant and just followed to the forest. Then he said, no, no, no. Even without gunas also, I would have served him. But gunas are added fragrance.